Hi, welcome to Wits Connect. This is Manoranjan. In this session, we will discuss about fax devices. Fax, flexible AC transmission system. So, fax devices mainly used in power systems, in transmission and distribution systems to improve the power transfer capability and to improve the reliability of the power. By the use of fax devices, overall transmission system efficiency will be increased. So that's why we will prefer fax devices. So what is the importance of fax? Without fax, what are the problems will raise? So generally, in power systems, power system is interconnected. Why we need to go for interconnection? What are the problems in present AC transmission system? Why we need to go for HVDC and fax devices? So all these things will be covered in this session. Okay. So mainly power system stability plays an important role. So first of all, what is the stability? When a system is subjected to disturbances, if the system is able to gets into its original steady state condition after getting a disturbance, after getting a delay, then the system is said to be in stable position. So what are the different types of stabilities? How they can define? What is the importance of stability, classification, and all these things will be covered. Generally, stability is a system. Let us assume if the initially the system is running in steady state condition, if the system is gets deviated from its stable condition due to sudden variations of load or any other problem, with a delay, if the system is able to get into its initial condition, initial stable condition, then the system is said to be stable. So stability mainly classified into voltage stability, dynamic stability, frequency stability, rotor angle stability. Okay. So what are the problems encountered in present AC transmission systems? To overcome those problems, we are going for fax devices. So mainly main purpose of fax devices is to increase the power transfer capability and to keep power flow over designated routes. అంటే గ్రిడ్ ఉంటుంది కదా, సో పర్టికులర్ ఏరియాలో ఏ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ వస్తున్నాయి, ఏ ఏరియాలో లోడ్ ఎక్కువ ఉంటుంది, లోడ్ ఫ్లక్చుయేషన్స్ ఎలా ఉన్నాయి, సో వాటిని బట్టి లాసెస్ని ఎలా మినిమైజ్ చేయాలి. సో జనరల్లీ ఇన్ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ సిస్టమ్ యాక్టివ్ అండ్ రియాక్టివ్ పవర్ అండ్ లైన్ రియాక్టన్స్ ప్లేస్ అన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ రోల్. సో ఇఫ్ ద డిమాండ్, యాక్చువల్లీ డే బై డే పవర్ డిమాండ్ ఈస్ ఇంక్రీజింగ్, ద డిమాండ్ ఈజ్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ ద జనరేషన్, దెన్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ విల్ అకర్స్. Generation should meet the demand. Demand will be always in increasing state only. Okay. So to meet the demand, generation has to be increased. So generation, further increasing generation, further to increase the generating capability, if it is not possible, then next step is what are the losses in transmission system to meet the demand. So first of all, we need to overcome the losses. So how the losses can be minimized? So what are the losses and problems encountered in the system? How we can overcome those problems? So to understand the problems and to overcome the problems, we are going to use fax devices. So loading of transmission lines near to their thermal limits. Thermal limits mean temperature capability. If the reactance increases beyond its limits, that may cause to increase the loading effect. That means demand increase. As the demand increases, generation is not sufficient to meet the demand. In that case, temperature losses and thermal limits comes into the picture, and that causes to damage the system. How the system gets damaged? Because as the reactance increases with the load, then there will be a drop in the voltage and frequency that affects on the generating plants, and that collapses the overall system. So that's why we need to estimate the problems due to temperature and stability, and those problems and with should be within the limits. If they increase beyond the limits, then the overall transmission system will be collapse. So to increase the reliability and to minimize the losses, overall transmission system is interconnected. Main purpose of interconnection of transmission system is to improve the stability, to improve the power transfer capability, to increase the efficiency of the system. And prevention of cascading out is by contributing to emergency control. In case of any fault occurs, for that particular area only, we need to give trip signal. So that's why we are using substations. From generating station to grid, grid to substations. Substations to the load centers. So damping of oscillations that can threaten security or limit the usable line capacity. So if the load may not be always constant, based on the load fluctuations, reactor's component and reactive power will be changed. So based on that, active power will change. So main intention is transferring real power or active power to the load should be constant, and the transferring capability should be more. In transmission system, reactance component should be there, but it should not be more. If reactive component increases beyond the limits, that may cause to increase the harmonics and losses. So based on the reactance component, ground clearance may not be constant, and it may affect on environment condition, and due to windage, weather conditions, losses will be increased, and thermal limits may be increased. So generally, basic types of compensation: series compensation, shunt compensation, and combined series compensation, combined series shunt compensation. So to increase the power transfer capability, already we discussed in power systems regarding nominality and nominal pi method. So by connecting a capacitor at the middle of the line, at the sending end or at the receiving end, so based on the compensation, so generally transmission line is inductive nature. So by connecting a capacitor leading nature, line lagging nature. So if is there any losses occurs, this leading capacitor compensate the lagging, so that resonance may occur, and that causes to increase the power factor and losses can be minimized. That's why we will prefer compensation. So why do we need transmission interconnection? So first of all is delivery of electric power from generating station to the load center, and to minimize the total power generation capacity and fuel cost. Fuel cost means the transportation and transmission system maintenance point of view. And to supply electricity to the loads with a minimum cost and required reliability. Reliability should be high. And the cost of the electric energy should be bearable with each and every common person also. Transmission is an alternative to a new generation resource. Means we need to minimize the losses. So by connecting lightning arresters, insulators, all these things will be covered on the maintenance. Economic energy or reserve sharing is constrained by transmission capacity. So for these reasons, transmission system is interconnected. Next, can we use the full potential of transmission interconnections? Okay. So as power transfer grow, because day by day demand increasing, so we need to erect the new transmission systems from substation to the load center. So power transfer grows, system becomes more complex to operate. So to improve the power transfer capability and to maintain the maintenance, means tripping signal, load maintenance with the scheduling, because in daytime power demand will be different, in morning hours and evening hours power demand will be different. So based on these fluctuations, how we can manage the plants or systems. The power systems of today are mechanically controlled. If so, what? If the power system's mechanical control, then what's the problem with that? Switching devices are mechanical, and there is a little high speed. Switching device means circuit breakers, relays. Okay, so based on the tripping speed and how much time they will take to clear the fault, so based on this, transmission system. So mechanical devices cannot be initiated frequently because of moment of inertia, and mechanical devices wear out quickly because they suffer from mechanical forces, wear and tear stresses. And day by day power demand is increasing, so to meet the increased power demand, absence of planning leads to less security and reduced quality of supply. So to meet the demand, there should be a proper planning and a reliable power supply with efficient operation in a reasonable cost to the consumer. So main purpose facts is to control and enhance the usage capability of the line. That means we should minimize the transmission losses. So facts controllers uses main purpose are to control the current through the line at reasonable cost, enables the power to flow from normal and contingency conditions, to control the interconnected parameters, that is series impedance and shunt impedance, current and voltage, phase angle. These are the main factors. That is, by using compensation method, we should increase the power transfer capability. In nominal T and nominal pi method, by connecting a capacitor at the sending end or at middle of the line, capacitor is a leading nature and transmission line is the lagging nature. So lagging reactance is nullified or compensated by the leading capacitive reactance, and then overall reactance can be minimized or nullified and the power factor becomes unity. But practically power factor may not be one, but it becomes very near to unity, so that the efficiency of the power system is increased. And to minimize the oscillations at various frequencies below the rated frequency, and to enable a line to carry power closer to its thermal rating. Thermal rating is an important factor. So for this, we are using insulators, arresters, lightning arresters, surge arresters are there. And mechanical switching is replaced with power electronics, that is the GTO, thyristor control reactors. SCRs and GTO, IGBTs have many applications in power systems to improve the efficiency of transmission system. So power flow in AC system. In AC system, electrical generation and load must be balanced at all times. That is, generating capacity should meet the required power demand. Otherwise, if the demand is increasing, that means increase in losses. So losses should be minimized. Electrical system is a self-regulating system, but it's not completely self-regulating, but to some extent, by using automatic voltage regulators, stabilizers and DVRs. If the generation is less than load, voltage and frequency is drop, and that affects on plant capacity and which causes to collapse the overall transmission system. So active power flows from surplus generation areas to deficit areas. Power flow or transmission power is possible in parallel lines and mesh system. Generally, we will use HVDC system because in AC system, due to skin effect, we have more losses. So to minimize the losses, HVDC is better. But HVDC transmission system is a more cost-effective function. That's why we are using FACTS devices in AC transmission system. So, FACTS, flexible AC transmission system. So main limitations are thermal, dielectric and stability. So thermal conditions are based on wind condition, weather condition and ground clearance between the wire and the ground. If the ground clearance is not good, that causes to affect on the reactive component, which causes to increase the voltage and frequency drop, and that will affect on stability of a system. And stability is the major factor. Stability is classified into rotor angle stability, dynamic stability, voltage stability, transient stability. So steady state stability, transient stability means steady state is the constant, transient is based on the load fluctuations, how the system behavior will be changed. It's a time dependent function. And if the load fluctuates, how it affects on plant, generator or rotor rotate rotating rotor rotating position. So all these things will be covered in the next class.